This is your brain. How it understands the world and creates intelligence is one of the most important questions of all time. If we want to know ourselves, and if we want to create intelligent machines, we need to first understand how the brain works. This part of the brain is called the neocortex. The neocortex is responsible for everything we consider intelligence: seeing, hearing, abstract thinking, language, arts, and science. It learns a model of the world in your head. The model recreates the structure of everything you know. Everything you do and experience is based on this model. Intelligence is the ability to create this model of the world. But how can a bunch of cells create a model of the world and everything in it? The thousand brains theory answers this question with a surprising insight. Consider a coffee cup. Neuroscientists used to think there was only one model of the cup. Since we can recognize the cup by touching it or seeing it, the inputs from the eyes and skin would connect to the single model of the cup. But when we look at the neocortex, it is composed of about 150,000 units called cortical columns, each about the size of a grain of rice. We now believe that each column independently creates models based on what it's sensing. Therefore, there are thousands of models of the coffee cup distributed among thousands of columns. Some columns get inputs from different parts of the skin. They model what the cup feels like. And some columns get inputs from different parts of the eyes. They model what the cup looks like. But then why does the coffee cup seem like one thing, not thousands of separate things? Some of the cells in the neocortex send signals long distances. They're like wires that go from the left side to the right side, from the front to the back. What these connections do was not known. The thousand brains theory proposes that these connections allow the different models to talk to each other. In essence, they allow the different models to vote to reach a consensus, a singular perception of what we are sensing at any moment. We are not consciously aware of what's going on inside each column, but we are consciously aware of the activity in the long-range connections between columns, so we are aware of the consensus reached by all of the columns. This is why we have a singular perception of the world. But how do columns actually learn models? The neurons in each column create something called a reference frame. A reference frame is similar to a map, or similar to the X, Y, and Z axes of coordinates. The reference frames in columns allow the column to represent the three-dimensional structure of the world. Everything we know, every fact and piece of knowledge we possess is stored at locations in reference frames. This insight resolves many profound mysteries of what it means to know something, how we see analogies, and how we solve problems. And it also tells us what we need to do to create intelligent machines. To date, we've managed to make machines that outperform humans on a few difficult tasks. But they are not intelligent. They cannot reason or learn about the world like we do. The thousand brains theory provides not only an explanation of how our brains work, but also a blueprint for how to build truly intelligent machines. These machines will think faster than we do, sense more than we can, and travel to places that we could not survive. Intelligent machines will extend the reach of humanity. If you would like to learn more about the thousand brains theory and our progress on machine intelligence, visit us at www.numenta.com.